Welcome back to my channel Math School. In today's video, let us solve question number 2 from exercise 11.2, chapter 11, Introduction to Trigonometry. In my previous videos, I have completed examples 1 to 8, exercise 11.1 and question 1 from the same exercise. If you have not watched these videos, do find the link in the description box below or click the I button above. And also do watch the whole video till the end. Try to practice the problems which I am solving here. So now quickly, let us begin with the video. Question number 2 from exercise 11.2, chapter 11, Introduction to Trigonometry says, choose the correct option and justify your answer. So there are 4 parts of the question and they have given us 4 options in each question. So we have to solve each question and find out which one is the correct option here. So let us solve this question one by one. Let us solve the first part of the question, which says 2 tan 30 by 1 plus tan square 30. We have to find out the value of this. So first, let us see what is tan 30 value by writing down the table which we have to know to solve the such kinds of problems. So this is the table. In my previous videos, I have also shown you the trick how to remember this table without memorizing it. So please do watch my previous video. That is question number 1 from the same exercise. Now let us find out the value of 2 tan 30. Here tan 30 is how much? It is 1 by root 3. So let us substitute the value in the given equation. So it is 2 into tan 30, which is 1 by root 3 divided by 1 plus, here we have tan square 30, so we have to square tan 30 term, which is 1 by root 2, so 1 by root 3 the whole square. So now we will simplify this equation. So 2 into 1 by root 3 will be 2 by root 3 divided by 1 plus square of 1 by root 3 will be how much? Square of 1 is 1 and square of any root number will be the number itself, because see, root 3 the whole square, if you consider the square and square root term will get cancelled. So we will have 1 by 3. Now let us take the LCM of this denominator and let us keep this numerator as it is for now. So taking the LCM here, the LCM will be 3. So 3 into 1 will be 3 plus 1. So this will be equal to 2 by root 3 the whole divided by 3 plus 1 is how much? It is 4 divided by 3. Now let us convert this division here into multiplication by taking the reciprocal of the denominator, right? So this is how we convert the division into multiplication by reciprocating our denominator. Here it is 4 by 3, so it becomes 3 by 4. So here we can cancel 2 1 times 2 2 times. So the result we get here is 3 divided by 2 root 3. Now here 3 can be written as what? Root 3 into root 3. What is root 3 into root 3? Will also be equal to 3. So let us write 3 in the terms of root 3 into root 3 so that we can cancel this root 3 in the denominator. Okay, so 3 can be written as root 3 into root 3 divided by 2 root 3. So here root 3 and root 3 and will get cancelled and the result will be how much? Root 3 by 2. So what is the value of root 3 by 2? Let us check in the option here. So let us check the first option. What is sine 60? Sine 60 is root 3 by 2. Okay, so this will be correct. If we come to other option, what is cos 60? Cos 60 is not root 3 by 2, right? Again, if you go to tan 60, it is also not root 3 by 2. And when you come back to sine 30, it is also not root 3 by 2. So the correct answer is sine 60, which is root 3 by 2 according to the table. So our correct answer will be sine 60, which is equal to root 3 by 2. Okay, now similarly we will solve the other parts of the question. So our second part of the question is 1 plus tan square 45 divided by 1 minus tan square 45. So we have to find out the value of this. So again, let us refer back to our table to find out the value of tan 45, which we will substitute here. Okay, so what is tan 45? Tan 45 value is 1. So substituting, we will get 1 plus tan square 45. So we have to square the tan 45, which is 1 divided by 1 minus tan square 45, that is 1 square again. So this will be how much? 1 plus 1 square is 1 divided by 1 minus 1 square is 1 again. So 1 plus 1 is 2 divided by 1 minus 1 is 0. Anything divided by 0 will be 0 only. So our correct answer is option D. Third part of the question is sine 2a is equal to 2 sine a is true when a is equal to what? So here we have to find out from these given four options what is the value of a such that sine 2a is equal to 2 sine a, right? So let us first check from the first option, okay? So now sine 2 0. So let us consider a is equal to 0 degree. So 2 into 0 will be 0, right? Sine 2 into 0 will be how much? Sine 0 only. So sine 0 is what? According to our table, sine 0 is 0, right? This is the left hand part. Now coming to the right hand part, 2 sine 0, okay? Here we are substituting a is equal to 0. So what is sine 0? It is 0. So 2 into 0 will be again 0 only. So our left hand side is equal to right hand side. So our option A will be correct. Okay. Similarly, if you can also check for all the other three options. So if you consider option B, let us substitute now a value equal to 30. Now what is 2 into 30? It is 60. So sine 60 is root 3 by 2, right? This is the left hand part. Now coming to right hand part. Now what is sine 30? Sine 30 is half. So 2 into 1 by 2. So 2 and 2 will get cancelled and you will be left with 1. But here the left hand part is not equal to right hand part. So option B is also incorrect. Similarly, when you check with option C, now what is 2 into 45? It is sine 90, and sine 90 is 1 equal to, again sine 45 is 1 by root 2. So 2 into 1 by root 2 is not equal, right? 1 is not equal to 1 by root 2. Again, option C is also incorrect. Coming to option D again, so 2 into 60 is 120, which is not possible. Again, option D is also incorrect. So our correct option is option A, which is when A equal to 0 degree, sine 2A is equal to 2 sine A. So exercise 11.2, chapter 11, introduction to trigonometry. So till then, do like my videos, subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to hit the bell button below to get the latest updates of my videos, as I'll be completing the whole syllabus for class 10th SLC and NSERT math. And also do watch the related videos of chapter 11, introduction to trigonometry, shown on the screen. Thank you.